This quick guide video provides an explanation of how to interpret the 10 test. Once the 10 test has been performed, it is important to identify whether a dead region is present. There are two criteria, and both of these need to be achieved before a dead region can be identified. Firstly, the mask threshold should be at least 10 dB above the level of the 10. And secondly, the mask threshold must be 10 dB above the non-mask threshold. Here is an example where a dead region is present. Notice the audiometric threshold of 50 dB at 2000 Hz. You can also see by the dial setting that the 10 has been introduced to the test ear at 70 dB. Now notice that the threshold in the 10 is 82 dB. The mask threshold is therefore 12 dB larger than the 10, which satisfies the first criteria. In addition to this, the masked threshold is 32 dB larger than the non-masked threshold. This satisfies the second criteria. In this example, we have successfully identified an area of off-frequency listening, and therefore a dead region is present. In the second example, we can see that the masked threshold is only 6 dB larger than the non-masked threshold. This would suggest a dead region is not present. But notice that the intensity of the 10 noise is not set correctly. With a pure tone threshold of 50 dB, the 10 noise must be set to 70 dB. But in this example, the clinician only made the threshold equalizing noise 5 dB larger than the pure tone threshold and set it to 55 dB. Therefore, this test does not meet the criteria required to identify the presence of a dead region. However, when the clinician increased the dial setting of the masking noise to the correct level of 70 dB and re-established threshold, we can see that the mask threshold is now 28 dB larger than the non-masked threshold. This establishes one of the criteria, but it is still only 8 dB larger than the 10 level. As this is smaller than 10 dB, it does not reach both criteria, and therefore a dead region is not present. By performing the 10 test and identifying dead regions, clinicians can save time and be guided in their clinical practice to provide the best outcomes for the patient. Firstly, it can be used to help counsel the patient and manage expectations regarding the potential benefits of hearing aids. Secondly, it can help the clinician select the most appropriate type of amplification. Identifying the dead region can also guide the clinician in how to program this particular amplification. Lastly, identifying dead regions is particularly useful in those which are cochlear implant candidates, as identifying the dead region can add weight to the case for cochlear implants. This concludes this quick guide video, which looked at how to interpret the 10 test.